Hello guys, it's your boy again, Max, on another video. It's been a long time, but I had to step back and do a few changes, as you can see. See how better to give you the best quality and the most creative way I can. I'm still learning, so far so good. I love this. Thank you to everyone that was checking out on me, like, yo Max, where the videos at? I'm like, ah, it's coming, and here it is. I'll be doing some series reviews. I've been doing mostly movies, but I'm seeing series more entertaining, and they are coming out continuously. So like the first one I did on the movie with the guy, the movie with the guy and the other chick. Yeah, just check on the tab below. It's coming up. So I did a review on a series, and then want to see how this one goes. So the first review I'm making is for the Irregulars on Netflix. Yeah, it was a very good series. I watched the first episode, and then I'm going to do a small review on exactly what I thought the episode was like, and if it's something you should watch. On my side, I think it's a very entertaining series, and it's something you guys should link up based on my first review. So I don't have sponsors, so we go straight to it. So the Irregulars, the first time I saw the trailer, it was just some teenagers going through some investigations, some bizarre mysteries around London, I think England. But at the end of the trailer, they show one of the girls going to apartment 221B. So if you're very good in your Sherlock Holmes, you know that 221B Baker Street is where Dr. Watson and Sherlock Holmes used to live together. So this was very exciting to me. Most people probably would not have gotten that from the first trailer, but the moment I saw that, I knew that it was some sort of Sherlock Holmes spin-off. And yeah, exactly, the second trailer showed that, yeah, it was. So it focuses around some of the things to do with Sherlock Holmes. So make sure you've seen Sherlock Holmes the movie with Robert Downey Jr. Amazing. And then the next one was Sherlock Holmes the series by Benedict Cumberbatch. So one became Iron Man, the next became Doctor Strange. So, well, yeah. So is it possible we can have this one of these teenagers in the Marvel movie? Okay, so yeah, make sure you watch those movies to get an understanding, or you don't even have to watch it since it's a spin-off, doesn't mention the past movies. But you, if you haven't read the books by Sherlock Holmes, watch the movie or the series, I would suggest you just watch the movie. The series is too long, just watch the movies and then get back to now this series, and then you can be able to understand, like, who is Sherlock Holmes, who is Dr. Watson, who is Alice, who is everyone. But there are not so many links to the movie and the series. So this is just another spin-off of a Sherlock Holmes movie, like the one we still had of the sister to Sherlock Holmes, still on Netflix. I think they have bought the rights to use Sherlock Holmes how they want and the family. So yeah, it was a very good series. I would recommend you watch it. Yeah, so let's start. So from the start of the series, we see a lady in her PJs walking down a very dark cave. Yeah, we've all seen ourselves there once in a while. Or is it just me? So from this, it's quite mysterious, since some of the things get to you learn as the episode goes. So it's her walking in a cave, a girl walking in a cave with a lantern, just trying. She seems lost, and there are a few lights passing through her in some supernatural way. And later on, she sees some dead skulls left, right, and center. So it's like a tomb or something, I'm not sure. And then there's a doctor. You remember the Assassin's Creed's doctors, the ones that wear the huge mask with a beak, and then to prevent themselves from getting infected, especially when they had the deadly disease, which we still have it, though I haven't seen someone with that mask, though it would be awesome. So yeah, and then she wakes up, so it was a dream. And that's when we meet Beatrice, that's the sister. But at first you don't know if it's the sister, so it seems like it's a relationship, because they're sleeping together and they are way too touchy. Yeah, so the introduction, you can see the room is a bit dirty. It's has a lot of candles, lots of candles. That's a fire hazard. And then the sheets are a bit dirty, so you know that they're not well off. Some of their clothes are torn, so you know they're from a very humble background. And then the start of it, you get a sister on top of B, and then she's screaming like it's her birthday. It's B's birthday. And then because they are poor, apparently she gives her an invisible gift. Come, I've never thought of that. So if you are my friend this year, you're getting an invisible gift, and I decide what it is. I can even give you a car, an invisible car, or Wonder Woman's invisible jet. That would be awesome. Yeah, I will give you an invisible jet. Just leave a like or a comment, and then you get yourself an invisible gift from me. It will be shipped by an invisible delivery guy. So yeah, it's a bit childish at first, and then you get to learn she's turning 17, and then the way they're behaving. I don't think I used to behave like that when I was 17, or any girl I know. So apparently she's single, and the young sister is advising her to get some.
Okay, fine. What is it?
Well, it's pretty obvious to everyone that you're desperate to find a boyfriend.
I don't want to find a boyfriend.
It's French perfume. Just two sprays make any man want to make sweet, sweet love to you. Almost too sweet, if anything.
I don't...
What's the legal age in England for someone to have sex? I hope it's 16, or else this got a bit weird. So that's the first episode, Unkindness in London. That's a mouthful. This is the chapter one, and then now we get to see the town, how the town is, how everyone. It's a downtown side of England. People, busy streets, very poor. You can see that from the shot. And then as B is walking up the stairs, she looks through a house and then sees someone checking her out. A guy, not weird at all. And then we are shown a close-up of 221B. That's Watson or Sherlock Holmes, I assume. So now I think as we have been introduced to the two sisters, now we get introduced to the friends. So we get to see some two guys, one black. Am I allowed to say black if they're from Europe? Do you say Europe, America, black European? Because in America it's African American, so this is African European. and another guy. So this guy is planning to fight one of the biggest guys, and I think they are the same age. So this guy is trying to fight a very muscular guy, and the guy should be around 17 or 18 at most. I still need to confirm the age restrictions in England so this can make sense, because if it's a 18-year-old hanging out with underage, that's weird. If they are the same age, then this guy is going to get some ass whooping. And then that's when B shows up, and then we cut off to some, now the opposite side of where they were staying, a guy in a very posh area. Then he's checking out friends from a window. So we get to learn that this guy staring at women wearing socks and getting turned on by that is actually the prince. The mother is the queen and has an issue. That's why, a medical issue, I think. That's why he cannot go out. So apparently it's also his birthday, and also B's birthdays. Ah, they're going to fall in love. I bet you my bottom dollar they are going to fall in love. What's the coincidence that they would both have their birthdays on the same day? So yeah, a bit predictable on this. But the next scene we get to see B now confronting the friends, like, why have they been why would they want to fight, and they would lose and probably get killed. And then the guy, that's when we get to learn that they are a bit low on cash and due on rent, and they are doing very bad in terms of their finances. Well, they are 17, everyone is doing bad because of their finances. I didn't even have finances. So yeah, that's when we get to see one of the most childish scene I've ever seen from a 17-year-old. So B is mad at them, and then goes and hides inside her blanket. Is it because they don't have enough rooms for her to storm off and go lock herself in? I don't get it. But she goes, puts a blanket on herself because she's mad. That's something my 10-year-old sister would do. Hasn't done, but I'm sure she might do it. But why would a 17-year-old be doing that? Again, what's the legal age in England for you to be an adult? And then the other friends, the two guys, they come and join her inside the blanket. Yeah. This is something that got into the script and was acted, and it's out. And when they come out, they meet that their sister is missing. That's what you get. That's what you get for doing some childish stuff. So they try to find her, and as she's doing a bit of daydreaming, she sees the doctor in the mask again, and then she almost gets run down by a carriage. And apparently the carriage is the one that is carrying the prince. I told you. And then the butler, or whatever this guy does, is trying to bully her, and then B stands up for her friends, and that's when the prince falls in love with her. Yeah, love at first sight. I told you. So yeah, I don't know how that works, love at first sight, but if you fall in love with me in this video, just leave a like and a comment down there. Would really appreciate it. YouTubers will do anything for likes and comments. And yeah, so the next scene we get to learn that B has lost her mom, and the nurse is there, and they're having a chat on how the mom went. We get to learn that she went a bit cuckoo, and B sees the same signs with her sister, I think. Yeah, it should be her sister, though they look nothing alike. I bet they're going to explain that. I hope they do. So, yeah, she says that probably her mother died alone since she does not see any flowers there. Then we get one of the weirdest scenes in this first episode. Like, while B was at her mother's grave, she hears someone coming, and then she starts running, and then the person is hot on her heels behind her. She runs, and then gets to a point and decides, you know, fuck this. Removes a knife and then threatens to kill. And this guy says one of the dumbest shit I've ever had. Like, why would you say this after you've been running after someone? 17-year-old girl in the dark. And then this guy continues and says, I've been watching you over my apartment in Baker Street, and I want something from you. Then says, I have money. And then I don't know if it's the intent of the director to do this, but the shortcuts to them in a pub and him ordering a room upstairs, and then they go to the room, and then this guy starts undressing, taking out his coat, and then the B is just seated there. I'm thinking, this took a turn. And then apparently he was just trying to have her and the friends help him in a mission, an investigation that they are doing that involves going into the less privileged areas, and probably a man of his stature, not him being black, no, the fact that he's well blessed in terms of finances cannot be able to get into those unblessed areas, and so they need her to help him in the investigation. So apparently children have been missing, kidnapped, and no cases of broken forced entry or any evidence to show that someone was actually there to steal the baby. So it shows a bunch of as he's narrating this, we are shown some of the events of the last kidnapping, and it's in a very, the editing is very well done, something that it's a callback to the Sherlock Holmes movies and the Sherlock Holmes series. Also, they usually did that when someone is narrating an investigation, they do some very fast clips of exactly what happened. And they also do that whenever Sherlock Holmes is doing a deduction of someone or something. So I hope they do this in this video. It's something I would like to see. It's one of the best things that happens in the Sherlock Holmes movies and the series. So yeah, so they are getting paid good money, and he knows they are not doing well, so they have to do this investigation. And as they do it, bunch of weird stuff happen. We get to see one of the victims or one of the witnesses in the case getting murdered by crows. Yep, crows. So it's something supernatural. It's a supernatural series that focuses around B and her friends. We get to learn each and every of the friends and how their characters are in terms of the first episode. And then the sister has another dream where she goes back now to the cave that we started off with, and then she meets with the doctor with the mask, you remember? And then this doctor is choking her. Get your mind off the gutter. No, not in a good way. And then out of nowhere, butterflies start showing up, and then she's transported to another place. and then she meets an old guy. It's super weird. Like, she's in a dream, but now some other old African European guy has transported her now to a safe place. They're just the two of them alone, and she tells him that he felt she was in danger and needed to save her, and now they're there together with an underage girl. So apparently this guy has almost the same powers as her, so he decides he's going to help her. So she needs to find out exactly where this darkness is coming from and what is bringing it alive, and how are people getting these powers. So nothing much happens this episode. It's just you learning exactly who the characters are. Probably in the following episodes you get to learn more and what drives them. Dr. Watson seems a bit off, so probably might end up being the main villain. I'm not sure, but he does look a bit off from the things he does, different from how he was portrayed in the movies, in the series, in the books. From this, he feels a bit off from the way he handles things, the way he feels entitled. Being a black man or African European. So yeah, for me it's a good movie. Check it out, and if you have, just leave a like and a comment. Tell me what you think. What other video you want. I'm planning to do Shadow and Bone, the first episode, and then you guys, yeah, that's all for me. Thank you so much for waiting. I hope this is exciting. You can tell me on the comments also what you think about this new design that I'm using, and then if I should change what I would add. Thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you for the long wait. It's been a long while. I hope you like this. I hope you enjoyed the review. I'll be doing much more of this. It was a bit of short notice just to see how everything is working according to my setup. But Shadow and Bone video coming up. But meanwhile, you can check out my previous videos from the playlist somewhere here. And then, yeah.